Okay, there we go. This should be able to work now. Anybody who has stuck around, I appreciate you. We're going to be getting into how to build your funnels. Gotta love the tech support, right? We're going to be getting to build your funnels and how to actually create the stages to that. Now, the importance behind everything, as I was sharing before we got so rudely interrupted by tech stuff, was that when we have the system set up, when you're generating leads, generating bookings, you're getting new clients, you're getting new customers into your business, it makes it so much easier for you to focus on other areas in your business. And when we can remove you from going out there into the field and, you know, manually going out there and trying to find clients or putting all the time into your machine so that your system can then go ahead and find the clients, we're going to build it out for you so that you know exactly what to use, how to use it, and when and why it's going to work. So now let's see if we can start sharing the screen real quick. Looks like we do have a winner. All right. So what we're going to do is pop into our slide presentation and let you know. So what we're going to do is talk about how to build your funnel. And then we're going to get into actually showing you what it looks like inside of my Kartra account. So this is going to be the value funnel, the branding funnel, the phase, the sales funnel. A lot of people do not stack their funnels like this. And that leads to a very high premium. So what we want to do as business owners and as marketers, we want to be able to make sure that we have the ability to bring in as many people into the front door as possible for a specific reason. That's going to get them to stay in our store, right, digitally, as long as possible. Now, in order for us to do this, we have to create an actual experience for them. Instead of just handing off a one-time flyer and then having them walk off to the end of the abyss and just never seeing from them again, never hearing from them again, we want to make sure we deliver an actual experience for these folks. Now, this experience is going to be comprised of these three specific funnels. So our job is to start delivering value up front. We will be generating bookings from this, or we will be generating sales from this exact funnel. That's one thing we will be doing. However, in order to get the cost at the lowest possible price point, plus shrink the actual time it takes for someone to make a better buying decision, meaning a bigger upgrade or a higher cost value in their purchase, that is going to come from phase number two and phase number three. So what we're doing here is we're actually stacking on value and value and value with trust and trust and trust. So we have the value funnel, the branding funnel, and the sales funnel. Value funnel, strictly for phase one. We're talking strictly to cold traffic. We really want to use this as the front door. You can retarget, you know, people on your list, but it wouldn't really make much sense. You would want to just send them an email and say, hey, look, here's this, or maybe it's something special that you want to retarget them with. But for the most part, you're using this for cold traffic, and this is going to help you generate new leads bookings for your business. And we're going to actually build that out for you. I'm going to show you how to do that today. And then when you show up next week, we'll go through what you've done on your own up to this point. So the branding funnel is going to be you sharing your philosophy, your methodology, and your tactics. This is what should get you excited. Some folks, when I share this with them, they get so nervous about what it is going to be required from them, right? They're like, oh my goodness, I have no idea if what I'm going to say, how I'm going to say it, is it going to be well received? Should I explain it? How do I explain it? What we've done here is with the way that we present the worksheets and the action items inside of the academy, and then you showing up to these calls, we're able to help you define your philosophy, methodology, and your tactics. Your tactics are going to be what are shown every day. These are going to be the ever-changing videos that are going to get you in front of your market as often as possible, solving relevant problems after they've shown interest from the lead magnet or after you pulled them organically. So these tactics are going to be ever-changing. This is going to be what you're going to stay up to date with, you know, being a part of the academy and staying on top of your own training outside of that and just making sure that you're ahead of the game. That's going to give you the ammo to create this new content every day so that you're sharing your tactics with your market. Then we want to build out a strong foundation that's going to help support your methodology and your philosophy. When you have that set up the way that it is, that's never changing, never changing, right? Think tactics are ever changing. And then you have the philosophy and the methodology, which are never changing. These are built on principles over here, right? This is a foundational principle that's not going to, it's like gravity, right? Gravity is not going to change, right? But how the tactic to get outer space will. Right? We've had all different types of things. And now we have better and better and better technology. So you can see the tactic is going to change, but the philosophy is going to stay the same. And so we want to make sure that your philosophy for your business is supported on a sound foundation. And then you want to build on top of that a methodology that can get proven results for you and your clients. Then on top of that, you want to create tactics that are going to keep you ahead of the game. That in phase two is going to just be built out with you demonstrating that you can help them and then using soft calls to actions at the very back end of those videos and following your client experience. So what is it that you want your client to experience? We want to take them from the funnel A, which is value, one of the milestones, right? Meaning What problem are we solving right up front? Then what's the experience we want to take? Do we want to announce who we are? Do we want to announce why we do things? How and what manner do we want to do that? How are we going to get them to know that you are trustworthy? Do we have case studies set up? Do we have webinars? Do we have something that's going to be able to help further demonstrate that you are the person for the job? Once we have that all lined up, either it needs to be created, or if it's already created, it's just positioned now into its correct spot. You'll notice some people, they go through with this branding funnel up front and they'll say, okay, well, I want to go ahead and build a brand first. And then with those people who are going to engage with my brand, those are the folks that I want to then run this lead gen funnel to. They got that backwards. They're doing it backwards. I've tested this so many different ways. And what we want to do is make sure that we're maximizing our space, maximizing our dollar, maximizing everything that comes through, right? And if that's going to happen, we got to make sure that we're giving value first. This is an argument that actually, or this is a process that actually proves my argument from the stand of time, from the since I began my business, was, you know, the chicken or the egg theory, which was, you know, what came first, the relationship or the value? What came first, the relationship or the value? Well, we tested relationship first. We tested, hey, here are the videos for the brand. Here's get to know us. We're here for you. You know, leading them with the exact same thing here, but put it up front. And what happened is the chance of getting somebody to engage with a 2-minute video or a 4-minute video on a repeat basis before you've actually shown them what you could do for them is ridiculous. And I thought it was ridiculous. But again, I wanted to make sure that I had numbers so that it wasn't just saying things based on my gut. I actually had and tested proof that, look, we put a lot of money. I spent about 6 months of testing. It was close to about 20 grand that I invested $25,000 into just that specific test. Okay, moving from brand funnel first into a value funnel. Did not work. So what we did is we reconstructed everything. We go now from a value funnel into a branding funnel. This allows us to further prove my point, which is which came first? The value. No one gives a damn about your relationship because there is no relationship if you can't establish value up front. Think about everybody in your life. How many people have you brought close to you that had no chance at ever giving you value? Whether it be the way you made intangible or tangibles. Right? It doesn't matter what kind of value it is. If you don't feel it's valuable to get to know this person, then the relationship's never going to get there to a point where it is considered a relationship instead of just an acquaintance. So we want to make sure that we're building this relationship by establishing value up front, building the trust through our brand funnel, and then delivering the sales process through a systematic fashion of direct response advertising campaigns. Right? This is going to help us get the best cost per acquisition after we've already built up the value, the relationship, the trust. They get to know us. They know a lot more what we can do. We start to really earn their business. And this is all done without you having to be out there in the field manually, right? These are the systems that we set up. This is what you're setting up right now. Now, we want to make sure we're staying clear of the webinar up front. I've made this mistake, okay? I've called it a masterclass. I've called it web classes, webinars. I've done everything. Can't get the cost per lead down to under $20, like on a consistent basis. I mean, I'm talking like $15 to $20, no matter what I do. Well, I switch it up. And again, you go with what we're teaching you. I just want to make sure that we have full proof that if you go against it, you're going to pay a premium. Yeah, you're going to get some results. It's great. You know, you can get people to watch your webinar, but you start doing the math and you're like, damn, $15 per registrant, only 30% show up rate. So that means I'm paying $45 per person to actually show up. And then I'm only getting about 15% of those people to go and watch the actual offer. So I'm only getting, I'm paying like $150 or something to get someone to watch my pitch. That's crazy when you can get the same thing for like $6, right? And so I'm going to show you how to do that today. And we want to make sure that that's why you're staying clear of web classes to cold traffic. You want to start with lead gen, then go into a sales letter, then go into a web class. Okay. These are things that are going to help you establish not only authority through their experience, but get them to really have a good time. This is what it should look like. Your first funnel, this is what you're looking at right now. You're looking at your landing page, your educational video on a sales page, right? We call it an educational VSL. We have your qualification page and your confirmation. Now, this is going to be a simple funnel. Now, you can have your calendar on the next page. So it can be educational video sales letter, button takes them to a page with a calendar. That can happen too. Either way is fine, but I wanted to show how simple this could be and how you can actually have a 4-step funnel that's generating bookings, leads, and getting you in front of people who are qualified to do business with you. This is what you're gonna set up inside your Kartra account or whatever tool you're using. I'm gonna share with you inside Kartra because that's what I use and that's what I'm going to continue to use. It's just the best tool that I've seen. The integrations are working great. So, or getting better, I should say. And I'm going to just, I've just seen it work a lot better than ClickFunnels in most cases. And WordPress, I've had a disaster trying to find developers to stay focused on that. And all the widgets and stuff are the same that are offered in Kartra to me. So just to me, if you want to go ahead and save on a headache, get yourself a Kartra account. I promise it'll work. So let's get into the individual funnel pages. This is what we're looking at. We've gone through the actual shell. We know what the funnels are going to be. We know what the big categories are going to be for each of these funnels. Now, within each of these funnels, there are certain different elements or certain pages that are going to be put into each of these funnels. Now, for the value funnel, we're going to go through that today. We're going to go through the landing page, the sales page, the qualification page, the booking page, and confirmation page. So the landing page you're going to see is very simple. Okay, it's each landing page that you're going to create is going to just offer a download. That's really what it is, or a series of videos, right? Or a video sales, a training of sorts. So it's going to be value, but that's all it is. We're going to be offering a download or a free training that will have five elements on that page. Those elements are going to be an acknowledgement. I'm going to show you what that looks like in a second. A headline, a hook, a call to action, and a compliance privacy policy. That's really all we're looking for. Then we have different testing elements for that. Keep the landing page simple. We're talking white background with dark text and a button with a clear call to action. That's what we're looking for. I'll show you exactly what I mean in just one second. We want to make sure that the privacy policy is there, because if you ever plan on marketing on Facebook, you're going to need that so that you can, when they crawl your site, when their little bots crawl your site, you've got to have that on there so that you can get put into the yes, I'm compliant category versus the I just want to get away with stuff because I'm lazy category. The sales pages are there to ensure that people engage. After they opt in, we want to have a fully and very precisely architected sales page that's going to get people to engage, read all the way through, get them to understand, or if it's a video sales letter, craft it to where they're going to get all the way to the end. That's what we want. We want a majority of people to watch all the way to the end. We want them to be engaged as possible. And then we want to split test between the video sales letter and the long form. That's going to be later on down the road if you don't have that set up. The first one you want to set up is going to be your video sales letter. This video sales letter is going to be the easiest thing for you to create. Number one, it's going to be like maybe 100 slides. I have the slide deck for you, right? It's going to be available for you inside of the members academy. So you have the entire slide deck, you have the entire transcription. You're going to have everything for you. That is a part of building out these solid funnels. It's testing these sales pages and knowing that, okay, video sales pages are going to work for a majority of people and sales pages are going to work for a majority of people. Just depends on where they're at. Can they watch the video, right? Sometimes somebody's going to see the ad twice and they're going to be happy that they can see it as a written version because they always see the ad in at work and they don't have headphones. So they can't actually read through it or listen to the whole thing because it's got noise to it. So we have to make sure that we're giving people what they want when they want it. And that's going to be on the sales page. Now we're going to go over that in the next, in just a second. Now the qualification page, this is our chance to thin the herd. So after you get somebody through this part and you've got them through the landing page, the sales page, qualification page, obviously chance to be clear, set expectations, what's going to be required of them. And then this is what we consider the takeaway part, right? We've done our job to give them a lot of free stuff and go, look, if you want this, follow me here. Okay. You followed me here. In order to go any further, you've got to meet these requirements. That's what we're doing here. And we want to make sure that they're held accountable along the way. The booking page, this is going to be our second to last opportunity to create a bond. So we have to make sure that we're clear on all expectations as to what's going to happen next and the consequences if they don't abide by the rules that you set forth. The confirmation page, after they're going to go ahead and book and everything's said and complete, this is the done, final, kaput, everything's good and ready to go. This is our time to shine. You want to make sure that we have an additional video, okay, that's going to be creating this sense of, hey, you know what? This is what you just signed up for. This is what you're getting. So make sure that you show up, extra. You make sure you lay out the rules again in the video. And you might be wondering, why are we doing this? Why are we we're saying in the sales copy, what's going on? We're saying in the confirmation, we're saying what's going on. We're saying in the booking page, what's going on. And then confirmation, we're going to wrap everything together that they just went through and just say it all again. Absolutely. Most of the time, people are going to skip steps in their mind and mentally, they're only reading or skimming through. So they're not paying attention to everything. It's our job at the end to make sure that we said, hey, look, you've gotten this far. That means that you've done this. So we expect this of you. This is going to help, again, thin the herd. It makes you only deal, and maybe not only, but in a high percentage, only have to deal with those that are real qualified and that are perfect for you because they get to hear your voice, your tone. They get to see, okay, well, who's this person that I'm going to be working with? Is there a chance that I might not like their attitude, the way that they talk, the way that they teach, the way that they train? Well, if that's the case, these videos are going to help that so that you guys can just move as far away from possible and you don't have to worry about having that as an awkward moment at the end of the close when they really don't want to tell you, hey, buddy, it's just the way that you train. It's really the way that you teach. It's really the way that you share this information with me that I don't want to move forward with. And that's a harder for a lot of clients and prospects to do. So it's our job to use a lot of these videos to do the heavy lifting for us. We know that this is the first time, especially when you're talking about the value funnel, right? This is the cold traffic. They've never seen or heard of us before. No one gets onto Facebook in the morning and says, hey, I cannot wait. You know what? I cannot wait to get onto Facebook and I'm going to find me a consultant today. I'm going to get me an agency. You know what? I'm going to go onto Facebook and spend $5,000 on a package, $15,000 on a, no one says that, right? But what happens is we end up getting in there because of the fact that we're speaking right to them and we're building up this trust throughout the process, right? So we know that we have to do a lot of the heavy lifting up front. We have to do heavy lifting with the ad copy, heavy lifting with the actual sales page, heavy lifting with the videos throughout the funnel. That's going to allow less pressure on your sales pitch, less pressure on the sales call. Does that make sense? And that's what we want to do is make sure that you are set up for success. At the end of the sales call, if you have everything that you need set up and they've gone through this process and you've been able to establish that credibility, then it becomes as easy as at the end of the call going, okay, so would you like some help putting all this together, right? Which is what we teach you. So let's get into what it looks like inside of Kartra, and then we'll close it out from inside there. All right. So inside Kartra, you're going to see, if you're using Kartra, a couple things that I just want to point out. I noticed that it might be a little, what's the word I'm looking for? Confusing for if you're brand new to Kartra and you're looking, well, I don't understand. Why does it say that, you know, my goals are 33%? I don't get it. I don't understand. Well, this is a campaign that we just started running. You can see it launched on like the 7th, I think. I'd have to see the week of the 7th, whatever day that is. And the week of the 7th, you could, which is 14 days ago, maybe. So sometime in the last 14 days, this thing launched. I have to check in the Facebook ad account. We started running this. You'll see that it's 33% here, but it's really 55 and 59. The reason why it looks less is because of these visitors. That's a combined total of all the leads that are going to the thank you page, or AKA my training page, right? Where my video sales letter is being actual hosted. So you'll notice what I'm sharing with you, the formula I'm giving you is working fantastically well. You're looking at 59%, and these are the two landing page variations. You'll see one has social proof and one does not have social proof. You'll see one's generating 59.6%. The other one's 55%. This is going to continue to hold. I'm pretty sure. I feel confident about it. And the reason why I'm smiling, the reason why I'm so excited about this is because it's very simple. When you have a clear idea about who it is that you're marketing to, because of the fact that you know who your market is, you know what problem you're solving, and you know why it's relevant to them have it solved right now, plus you have all the other things that we've gone through inside the academy with you understanding your differentiations, setting up your unique offers, and making sure that your entire base foundation is so clear that when you get to this point, it writes itself. It literally, you don't have to be a master copywriter if you go through the actual worksheets and the action items every week, which is why I set it up like that, because not everybody's gonna have time to become a master copywriter, right? I mean, I've been at this for like 5 years and I'd be damned if I'm anywhere close to being a master copywriter. I think I'm great, don't get me wrong. I will toot my own horn, but I'm not that person that's gonna say I'm the best in the room, not even close, right? Because I think it's one of those ever evolving things. Copywriting is changing just like fashion and anything else. It's never gonna be complete. We're always gonna be looking for new ways and angles to be able to create compelling stories and bring people closer to what we want them to do, which is gonna be ultimately a benefit for them. And you'll see here with a quick and easy landing page setup, we're looking at almost 60% landing goals and ratios, right? This is almost about 100, what are we at? Almost about 100 opt-ins right now. And we're sticking at above 50% on both pages. So let's look real quick at the actual site. When you get inside of Kartra, you'll go to pages, start to create these. And what's going to be great is when you get your Kartra tool, all you have to do is shoot me an email if it's not, if you don't find it in the actual academy, and I'll send you the unique link for you to download all these into your Kartra account. You don't have to worry about building a thing. Think about it. This is going to be built, this will be literally automatically put into your Kartra account. Let me go ahead and pull this up on an actual new window. And you can see how simple this is. This is the one with the social proof. This is the one that's getting the 59.4%. You can see everything above the fold is, look, everything above the fold is just, it looks normal. Like I said, you have a acknowledgement, we have a headline, we have a call to action, and then we have our compliance, privacy policy and compliance. There we go. This is, again, added on. This is an addition too. Not everybody's gonna have this, the social proof, but this is just letting people know that, look, when I say 20, 40, even 80 registered bookings, I mean, we're not joking. There's a lot of bookings that are going on, right? And then we have Lauren, my clients that have left reviews, and just, you don't wanna ever give too much. So we leave two reviews, right? 1, 2, 3 reviews, maybe video testimonials, whatever, maybe not video on this page. But you can see that how just a couple of images, this is now, might not seem like a lot to go from 54 to 59%, but in the whole pie of things, looking at the whole pie, we're looking at a 5% increase, right? And 55%, you have five, what's 5 of 55? We're looking at about 9%. So 8 to 9%, right? Something like that. Increase. That's pretty good when you can increase your landing page conversion by 8% just by adding a couple of images. So let's really dive into the different variations after we've gotten the foundation set up. The foundation is acknowledgement, headline and hook, and then you can see the hook is here, every month with predictability down to the dollar a day. So I missed that part the first time, I'm sorry. First type is the acknowledgement, second part is the hook or the headline, and then I have the hook in there. Sometimes we're gonna put the hook underneath, and it might be like an even if or a so you can or a without. So we can add in hooks at the very bottom underneath that with the subtext, and that's totally fine too. And then we have our call to action. And now that we have this foundation set up, it's like, okay, well, what do we want to test first? Well, we test social proof versus no social proof. And you'll see that one is definitely out converting the other. Now, it's still early on. I just wanted to share with you how this simple. Look how black text, white background, green button, and that's it. And then if we go to the next page inside the funnel, right, let's look at the sites when we have this. Oh, let me set this up. We're looking at the VP VSL case study. Now you see, look, this is all it is. We're not even running this page. This is another variation we were going to think about running. But right now, it's these two variations running to this page. This page runs to a qualification, to a booking, which then takes them to a qualification. And let's take a look at this. Look how simple it was to create this one. So anybody who's thinking, I don't have time to do this, I'm not sure if I can, it's, you know, there's really no excuse anymore, right? We've made it so simple that you can take the templates from inside Kartra, redo the video of your own using my screen slide, slide deck, and now it's just boom, upload it to Kartra and you have your entire funnel set up. Show up to the calls, we'll help you close, right? So that's what we're looking for. Step one, here's a video that explains it all. You can see I'm calling people out. The first thing matches the second thing. If we go to the first one, case study reveals how to get booking, registered bookings, right? Now I'm marketing to specifically these folks in my targeting. So my targeting is only to these people. So it makes perfect sense when they get here, registered bookings matches my advertisement. Everything's congruent. And we're looking at lead costs right now coming in at right around between $8 and $10, right? $8 and $10 between what we're looking at, or $5 and $10, depending on the audience that we're actually marketing to. So we haven't broken down. But those are everybody that we're bringing through this funnel. Once they opt in, boom, here's a video that explains it all. You can see it is a PowerPoint presentation. It goes all the way through and then it takes them to step two. Step two then gives them an opportunity, says sales and marketing. They go ahead and book. Once that booking takes place, it takes them to a page with a qualification form. And then after that qualification form, it takes them to the confirmation page. And that's what these two look like over here. We have the, well, pretty much, they all pretty much look like this. I'm not gonna make you waste any time, but they all look like pretty much like this. And then after they come through on this page, let that load. Then they're going to come through and get the thank you for booking call. I guess it's all down here. There we go. And I think I got a couple of these links off center, because you'll see, I think the, yeah, you'll see the, this one is an NN and this is an N. This isn't the right page for this. This is the right one. This is the right one. This right one. You can tell by the actual logo up top. So instead of, to save time, you'll see that they are going to come from here, go straight to this page, which is going to be the video sales letter case study that I created. Going to take them now after they book to the qualification call. Once they get to the qualification call, it's going to get to the confirm. This confirm is going to be the video I'm sharing with you that needs to re-encompass everything that they're talking about. This one is only 2.5 minutes. My video sales letter is 26 minutes, I think, 22 minutes. So I take them into from a legion that's going to give them a video sales letter case study on how I get X result for myself every single month with predictability down to the dollar and day. Then I take them to a booking. They book, takes them to an application form where they're going to give me more information about how I can help them on the call. Then they get taken to this video that says, hey, if you're at this point, thank you so much. You've now officially booked your call. Now it's official. Before it's been penciled in, now it's official. If you have any questions, come here and listen to this video. That's it. That's all it is here. That's the end. That's everything that we're looking for, right? And once this is set up, you are good to go. So I want to share you guys with that today in a brief walkthrough so you had a clear understanding about setting things up, the overview as the multiple funnels, right? The three funnels, phase one, phase two, phase three, value funnel, branding funnel, and then we have our direct sales funnel, our sales funnel. That is value pitch close. We're going to be using each phase to bring people through the levels of awareness so that when they get to the point of hearing and seeing our direct sales pitches that on our direct response campaigns, that they're going to be like, wow, this is really something that I need. This is something that I cannot wait to have. And these kinds of messages and the setup and the system is going to put you in a position to not sound like everybody else, to not wear out your market, and to put you in a, oh my goodness, I've got to stay ahead of the game. Because I love this. My VPC method is not good for folks who want to sit back on their laurels and go, oh, well, I want to use things that worked maybe 10 years ago, right? We have a foundation set up that's going to help your philosophy and your methodology not have to change. That's not going to change. But you better stay up to date with the tactics, right? You have to stay up to date with the tactics. This is ever evolving, and that's what you want to free up your time to actually focus on when you get the system set up. So instead of you having to stay up until 3 o'clock in the morning trying to figure out what software to use or what's the next best tool or this new marketing strategy, how are you going to test it? What's the best way to do a new JV? How are you going to get more PR? All these things are now going to free up this creative space in your brain when you have the system set up. And this is the very simple value funnel, right? Phase one to cold traffic, so that you could then start getting bookings and getting meetings and making sure that you're getting sales. So if you have any questions, make sure you show up to the group. I'd love to be able to answer anything for you there. And then we will be coming out in just a couple more days on the next members call. So I appreciate you all for joining me live today. I see y'all in. For those of you that are in the group, make sure to comment below if you have any questions. I'll see you guys on the next one. All right, you take care.